Hey, what's up, guys? I hope y'all are doing all right. I just wanted to hop on here and make a bit of like a feel-good video, something we can just kind of enjoy, talk about some nice things, and talk about the good that BSG is doing lately, or at least the good I believe that they're doing lately with these dynamic events that we have been blessed with. So I want to talk about what's been going on with that, how I feel about it, and a couple of events that I think would be really cool to add to the game too. So let's talk about it. All right, so if you live under a rock or you're just busy and unaware, BSG Battlestate Games lately in the past week has dropped a few events in Tarkov. They're not patch events, they're not wipe events. Well, I'm sorry, at least we don't know that for sure yet, but they're just events that they added basically unprovoked out of the blue. It all started on Factory with the sighting of Killa. The scab boss Killa, normally found on Interchange, has been roaming around Factory. He's been wild on there. It's been a lot of PvP, it's been a lot of fun. Killa on Factory. Personally, I don't love Factory that much, so that event was to me a little lackluster, but I get why it's so awesome to so many people. Because it is cool, it's something unique. Then a couple days later, we got an event that I really like personally. Every single scab boss in the game was being found on reserve, all at the same time with 100% spawn rate. Killa was the same way too, I believe. On Factory, it was 100% spawn rate. But reserve, every boss in the game was being found on reserve, still is at the time of me making this video. And I spent the entirety of my Saturday on reserve with my friends. We were playing all day long, hunting scab bosses, hunting players. We died so much, but we had such a blast. It really is something to be able to have that much action on that big of a map, as big as Reserve is. So that was Saturday, and then Sunday I woke up to yet another event, day three of the events extravaganza. Labs was free. You did not need, and still don't need, a Labs card to go play Labs. And now, when Labs first came out back in 0.11, this is how Labs was originally. You did not need to pay to get in there, and it was quite awesome to be able to go into such a high value map with almost next to nothing. If you wanted to do that, I used to run pistols there all the time to go in there and see what you could do with just a pistol and what you could come out with. So Labs is currently free right now, and that's not all. They threw Gluhar, the reserve scav boss, on Labs as well, along with 8 of his guards. Now normally I believe he has 6 guards on reserve, so they actually upped the guard count by 2 and put 8 guards on Labs with Gluey. I spent the entirety of Sunday playing Labs with my friends, again dying all day, but basically having the time of my life. And I'm gonna try and explain why, to some people that may not get it, why these events are actually so cool, so unique, and why I think there's so much fun. So I feel like if you're new to Tarkov and you're a bit of a new player, these events may not mean as much to you, because honestly, when you're new, everything in the entire game is scary, everything is unique, and everything is foreign to you. And it's kind of really easy to stay interested and keep, like, you know, that fear factor that you have when you first start playing that game. This game, you know, it's just really, you feel so much going through every map and playing this game when you're new. It's a blast, you know. Everybody remembers that feeling, or at least I hope you do, because it's a special one. But anyway, for those of us who've been playing for a while, not to say by any means that we have been playing so much that we've exhausted every possible, you know, scenario and outcome on every map, but these scab bosses being on maps are not supposed to be on, such as reserve, you know, having every scab boss, it creates new possibilities for fights and interactions that you've never experienced before. You've never run into Killa while trying to enter, you know, White Knight building on reserve, and you've never seen the massacre that ensues whenever someone does that, and then Sanitar shows up, and then more PMCs show up, and then it's just a madhouse, really. These events just kind of create new possibilities that no one's ever experienced before, and that's really exciting. Now, another thing that I really enjoy about these events is that, and this may be a bit of a weird one for some people, I don't know, this could just be a me thing, but I feel like other people have to experience this too. Let's talk about like MMOs for a second. You know, like World of Warcraft, okay? Whenever you play World of Warcraft, say you're a new player and you go play retail World of Warcraft, like you just get on, you've never played before, and you just start. What it is that everybody loves about that version of World of Warcraft, what it is that everybody's doing, everybody's playing, everybody's talking about, is the end game stuff, the very most current stuff for World of Warcraft. The thing is, there was a time where being that level one character, getting onto World of Warcraft, that was what everybody was doing at the same time. Which is why, for example, World of Warcraft Classic has been such like a smash hit for so many people. It's because it is fun to do the thing that everybody else is doing and enjoying with them at the time. Think of it kind of like a fad, if you want to put it that way. But basically, the reason that it's so much fun, these events that we're getting, is it's bringing everybody to these maps for the same purpose. There's like a good sense of camaraderie and a good sense of like togetherness within the community. Like, you know, when you go to reserve right now, you're gonna have other players there trying to do the same thing you're doing, trying to hunt bosses, trying to hunt other players down. Whereas sometimes EFT can start to feel very vast and empty, when especially when you get later in the wipe. It really collects everybody and brings a lot of people back in and really concentrates them on certain maps so that you can get a really good Tarkov experience on these couple of maps where the dynamic events are happening. And I think that's, for me, what I find most enjoyable about this whole thing, is just the sense of, all right guys, like, we're all going to reserve, everybody's going to be there, it's going to be a blast. It's that sense of like belonging, almost like that sense of, you know, you're doing the thing that everybody's doing right now, you feel included, if that makes any sense. At least I do. Like I said, that's might just be a me thing, but knowing that I'm going to go to reserve and I'm going to fight a bunch of bosses with everybody else on the map, and we're all going to fight for them and fight over them, knowing that we're going to go to labs and get full lobbies, and we're all going to be doing crazy stuff, some people with low gear, high gear, but we're all in there just to have a good time because, it, you know, it's free to get in there, we're just having a banger of a time. That sense of community and like togetherness and just sense of importance and focus on those maps right now is just like, I didn't want to get off Saturday or Sunday. I did not want to stop playing. I had to force myself to stop playing, knowing I needed to go to bed at a reasonable time so I could get up the next day and do it all again. And so I want to encourage you guys, because I've already said this on my stream. By the way, I'm a partnered streamer over at twitch.tv/finestxi. If you guys ever want to come talk Tarkov, links for the streamer down below. But I already said this to the stream. Go ahead, if you have Twitter or Facebook, go ahead and tweet or message Battlestate Games and let them know how much you enjoy these events that we've gotten and how they should do more of these in the future. I really do subscribe to the idea that as much as you, you know, criticize something, you should also praise it whenever it does something well or correct. So as much, you know, crap as Battlestate Games gets over desync, over cheaters, over decisions they've made, I think when they do something like this, they do these dynamic events that I and everyone I know is having a good time on, we need to let them know, so that way they know that this is something that they can, you know, do more of, because we want it to happen. So tweet at them if you have Twitter, I don't know, message them on Facebook, like however you can get to Battlestate Games, whatever social media platform they're on, let them know these dynamic events on Reserve, Factory, and Labs are awesome, and they should definitely do more of this stuff in the future. Now, I do want to talk about two events that I'd like to see. They haven't done yet, but I'd really like to see these events be done, at least maybe at some point, if not now. The first one is not my idea. I believe it was my friend JDream's idea. He said he'd like to see an event with multiple killas on Interchange. Now, I can't imagine anything scarier than multiple killas on Interchange. That really is the stuff of nightmares, and I could see how brutal it would be to walk into the mall and maybe even put him on, you know, parts of the map where he's not normally at too, and you just never know what is going to be safe or where there's going to be a killer hiding. And it may seem a little silly to some people, you know, this one's probably less possible than other events because I don't think they would ever duplicate a boss, but I think it could be a really fun event and it could bring a lot of people to Interchange for a common cause. So the first event I'd like to see, you know, if I had my way, it would be multiple killers on Interchange. I think that'd be hilarious, terrifying, amazing, all of the above. The second event that I'd like to see is one that I really think could happen and that we need to happen. I want to see an event where they bring cultists out in droves in daytime, like 100% spawn rate for cultists on a certain map. We can say, you know, like Woods or Shoreline, for example, or maybe even Customs. I have played so many night raids, arguably more night raids than most people, and I have only ever run into cultists one time. I've hunted them down, I've tried to seek them out, and I just had no luck. And I really think that something so cool that's been added to the game really needs to be experienced by more people, if for nothing else than to get people exposed to it so they want to hunt them down after the event is over. I don't feel like enough people have experienced the cultists, and I'd like to see like 100% cultist spawn rate on a map, so that way you can see what they're like, you can see how scary they are, you can get used to fighting them, you can just, you know, experience that really cool thing that got added to the game that I think a lot of people haven't gotten to even taste because they're just so hard to find. Or maybe it's just me. Like I said, I found them one time ever. I might be an anomaly. Maybe they spawn a lot for everybody else, but I just never find them. I'd love to see an event where they do 100% cultist spawn rate day or nighttime. I think that would be really cool. And it's not something that's impossible. You know, they've done raiders on maps where raiders don't normally spawn, and they've replaced all the scavs in the game with raiders. So this, I don't think this is too difficult or would be too out of the ordinary for them, for Battle State to do something like this. But yeah, I just wanted to hop on here and do a quick one talking about these events because I love them so much, and I hope everybody else does too. Let me know in the comments down below if you guys are enjoying these events, or maybe it's just me, but let me know in the comment section. Also, give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, thumbs down if you didn't. Subscribe to the channel because we put out a ton of Tarkov content, and like I said earlier, I do stream on Twitch full time, so if you guys want to talk Tarkov, come stop by, say hello, I'd love to meet you. Anyway, I'll stop rambling. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one.